strong and contagious. Now, more than ever, we must continue to spread sensitivity to others and a true understanding of what it means to be a survivor. This is urgent. We must show the world why this matters. In this fight to end the silence, every voice counts, and this is why I thank you all again for coming today. I believe that a survivor's greatest asset is their support, and to see you all here together is a beautiful sight. It is a reminder that we do have support because we have each other. Thank you.
This performance piece that you were doing throughout the year, talk about how you came up with this idea.
Well, I first came up with the idea when I was at an art residency this summer, and I was making a video where I had to move a mattress out of a room, and sort of the idea of me carrying a mattress got stuck in my head, as a song might get stuck in someone's head, and I unpacked the image and realized all of the symbolic importance of what it would mean to carry a mattress around with me at Columbia, and I realized I had to do it.
What does it mean?
Well, in my case, I was raped in my own bed. And of course, rape can happen anywhere, but for me, it sort of desecrated one of the most intimate and private places of my life. And the way that I've brought my story from a place that I keep secret out into the public eye sort of mirrors carrying the mattress itself out into the light for everyone to see. So I felt like it would be an appropriate metaphor.
When did the attack happen?
It happened on the first day of my sophomore year.
And what did you do about it afterwards? Who did you report it to?
Immediately afterwards? Well, at first I didn't even tell my parents. I was very ashamed, I felt disgusting, and I didn't want to talk about it at all. But after I met other women that my rapist had attacked as well, I realized that if I didn't do something, he would continue to rape other students on our campus. So that's when I decided to report it to the school.
And what did the school do?
Completely mishandled my case. For one, they allowed my attacker to postpone it for 7 months, which was long enough for one of the women who reported to graduate because he had academic conflicts like midterms and essays, which we all have. One of my hearing panelists kept asking me about whether there was lubrication involved because she didn't seem to understand that anal rape could happen without it, which of course is ridiculous because rape is forced and that's exactly how it works. And that's why I was in pain. And
she asked you to explain this in front of the panel.
Yeah. And then the investigation itself was a total mess. The investigator didn't even include the position I was in when he raped me in the report that was ultimately given to the hearing panel because I guess she didn't think it was an important detail, even though I repeated it multiple times. The list goes on, but...
And what did the panel find?
They found him not guilty of assaulting me.
In the case of the other two women, another woman went to before the panel like you did?
Yes, another woman. One woman was denied a hearing because they told her she didn't even have enough evidence to have one, which I believe is the hearing panel's decision to make, but the school decided to cut her off short. And the other woman had the hearing. They found him guilty of groping her at a party, but then he submitted an appeal to the dean of his college, who, by the policies, has full autonomy to decide the case however he wants. So he, Dean Valentini, convened an entirely new hearing panel, even though the woman had already graduated, with hearing panels who'd never heard her voice. And of course, they found him not guilty in the new hearing.
So right now, you are dragging this mattress everywhere you go on campus?
Carrying it, yes.
And do people help you?
Yeah, most of the time, as soon as I leave the room, someone will jump in and help me. But a lot of people will even come up to me and say, thank you so much for what you're doing, and then walk next to me while I carry it.
And what has been the university's response?
They have yet to reach out to me. They've mentioned perhaps mentioned my piece in an email to the university where they said something like, we respect individuals' rights to protest peacefully or something like that, but they have yet to contact me directly.